China's investment in Africa is booming. Some call it a win-win, others a debt trap. Is Africa being colonized all over again? For centuries, Africa was dominated by European powers. Today, China's economic presence is undeniable. Is this a new chapter in the story of African colonialism? Africa has a long history of being colonized by European powers. These countries seized land, resources, and often forced Africans into labor. This left a lasting impact on the continent's development. But in recent decades, a new player has emerged on the scene: China. Economic ties between China and Africa have grown tremendously, with China becoming the continent's biggest trading partner. Before I share some facts, which I am sure you will be interested in, let me share some background information. Perhaps China is a lesser evil and far better than the West. Of course, you don't want to make anyone your enemy, but looking at what the West did to Africa, it's safe to say China hasn't done any worse. To put this in a simple statement, the West built infrastructure in Africa during the colonization period for the purpose of extracting resources. For example, the trains built during the colonial era were for the purpose of moving agricultural products or solid minerals extracted from the mainland to the seaports. In contrast, China is currently building hydropower stations, airports, roads, etc. But at what cost, you ask? Well, it's not China's fault that African leaders cannot negotiate a good deal with China's investment organizations. There is no free lunch anywhere, and China will also do anything they do for their own interest. It is up to African countries to also negotiate better. Am I saying China can do whatever they want and indirectly colonize Africa again or neo-colonize Africa? That's not my point. Anyways, let's now go into the details of China's dealings in Africa, and hopefully you can stay with me as I discuss them in detail. Is Africa being colonized by China? China's economic footprint in Africa is profound and multifaceted, establishing the nation as a trade powerhouse on the continent. China stands as Africa's leading trading partner, engaging in the exchange of goods more extensively than any other country. This robust trade relationship underscores China's dominant economic presence. Additionally, China is heavily invested in building Africa's infrastructure. From constructing crucial roads and railways to developing comprehensive transportation networks, these projects are pivotal for enhancing trade and fostering overall development in African nations. China's interest in Africa also extends to the continent's abundant natural resources. By investing in resource extraction projects, China secures access to vital materials such as minerals and oil, which are essential for its industrial needs. These investments are a key component of China's strategy to support its own economic growth while simultaneously contributing to Africa's development. However, China's economic involvement in Africa is not without its complexities. The nation has extended substantial loans to African governments to finance various projects. While these loans are instrumental in facilitating development, they also raise concerns about the long-term economic implications for African nations. The potential debt burden resulting from these loans is a critical issue, highlighting the need for careful management of financial relations between China and Africa. China's actions in Africa have drawn comparisons to colonialism due to several key factors. One significant argument is the lack of local control over resources. Chinese investments often involve taking control of local mines, oil fields, and other natural resources, leaving African nations with limited authority over their own wealth. This mirrors colonial practices, where colonial powers exploited resources for their own benefit, often at the expense of local populations. Additionally, environmental damage caused by resource extraction is a major concern. Chinese companies operating in Africa have been criticized for disregarding environmental regulations, leading to pollution, deforestation, and habitat destruction. This environmental degradation is reminiscent of the colonial era, when natural resources were extracted with little regard for ecological consequences. The debt burden on African nations is another point of contention. China has provided substantial loans to African countries for infrastructure projects, but these loans come with high interest rates and stringent repayment terms. Many African nations struggle to repay these debts, leading to fears of economic dependency and loss of sovereignty, similar to the financial manipulation and exploitation seen during colonial times. The importation of Chinese labor for projects has sparked criticism. Instead of employing local workers, many Chinese-funded projects in Africa rely heavily on Chinese labor. This practice limits job opportunities for local populations and can create social tensions, echoing the colonial practice of importing foreign labor, which often undermined local economies and social structures. In examining the differences between China's involvement in Africa and traditional colonialism, several key distinctions emerge. Unlike colonial powers that prioritized direct political control and governance, China's approach centers primarily on economic gain. This economic focus is evident in their extensive trade relationships and investment in the continent. China engages in a non-interference policy, consciously avoiding involvement in the internal political affairs of African governments. This contrasts sharply with the colonial powers that often imposed their political structures and systems on the colonies. Additionally, China's investments, particularly in infrastructure projects, are often seen as beneficial to the host countries. These projects can lead to improved transportation, better energy resources, and enhanced technological capabilities, contributing to the overall development of African nations. While there are criticisms and concerns about debt dependency and long-term economic impacts, the immediate benefits of infrastructure development present a more mutually beneficial relationship compared to the exploitative nature of traditional colonialism. The future of China-Africa relations presents a complex and multifaceted landscape with several potential scenarios that could unfold. One possibility is the continuation of the robust economic partnership that has developed over recent decades. This relationship has brought mutual benefits, with China investing heavily in African infrastructure, manufacturing, and natural resources, while African countries have gained access to Chinese markets, technology, and capital. Such a scenario could see both regions continuing to thrive, fostering greater economic integration and shared prosperity. However, there is also the concern of an increased debt burden leading to a growing dependence on China. Many African nations have borrowed substantial sums from Chinese financial institutions, raising fears of a debt trap that could undermine their sovereignty and economic stability. In this scenario, the imbalance in the relationship might deepen, with African countries potentially facing significant challenges in repaying their debts and managing their economies independently. Another possible future involves greater transparency and the establishment of fairer trade deals. This would require both China and African nations to adopt more equitable practices in their economic engagements, ensuring that investments and agreements are conducted with clear, mutually beneficial terms. Increased transparency could help mitigate some of the criticisms related to debt and dependency, fostering a more balanced and sustainable partnership. As we consider these scenarios, it is crucial to think critically about the evolving dynamics of China-Africa relations. While the economic benefits are evident, the long-term implications of these engagements must be carefully weighed. Encouraging transparency, equitable trade, and responsible borrowing can help shape a future where both regions can prosper without compromising their economic sovereignty. Some warning signs of China's influence on Africa. China's influence on Africa has manifested in several ways that raise concerns about the nature and extent of this relationship. One notable example is the construction of the African Union, AU, headquarters in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, which was fully funded and built by China. Completed in 2012 at a cost of $200 million, this gesture was intended to symbolize the strong ties between China and Africa. However, reports emerged in 2018 alleging that the building's computer systems had been bugged by Chinese contractors, leading to fears of espionage and an undue influence over the AU's activities. China's financial footprint in Africa is also significant through its investments in key financial institutions. China holds a substantial share in the African Development Bank, AFDB, and the African Export-Import Bank, AfreximBank, which are critical players in funding development projects across the continent. This financial leverage gives China considerable influence over the economic policies and priorities of many African countries, raising questions about the long-term implications of such dependency. Another visible sign of China's influence is the presence of Mandarin language signs in several African countries, symbolizing the deepening cultural and economic ties. For instance, at Bole International Airport in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, signage is prominently displayed in Mandarin, reflecting the high volume of Chinese travelers and the significant Chinese investment in Ethiopian infrastructure and industry. Similar examples can be found in other countries where Chinese companies have undertaken large-scale projects, further embedding Chinese cultural elements into the local environment. The issue of indebtedness is particularly pressing, with several African nations heavily indebted to China. Djibouti, for example, has borrowed substantial sums from China, raising concerns about its ability to manage and repay this debt. Similarly, Zambia has faced scrutiny over its increasing debt to Chinese creditors, which has fueled debates about the risk of losing control over critical national assets. These debts often come with conditions that may favor Chinese interests, further entrenching China's influence over these nations' economic and political landscapes. These examples highlight some of the warning signs of China's growing influence in Africa, which can have far-reaching implications for the continent's sovereignty and future development. As African countries continue to engage with China, it is crucial to critically assess the terms and impacts of these relationships to ensure they are mutually beneficial and sustainable.